Meet George Hernandez, who attended Cesar Chavez Elementary School, then Hall School in the 1950s. He went to Burton Middle School, graduated from Central High School. Early on in his career, he started coaching football and softball. How did that happen?
I was playing basketball at Burton Junior High outside in the summertime, and some little boy walked up to me and said, "Hey, you know, do you know anybody that coaches?" And I said, "No, I said, get out of here." You know, we're playing basketball, and then all of a sudden he turned around and started crying. And I said, "Time out, guys. I want to talk to this kid." I said, what's your problem?" And he goes, "Nobody cares about us." And I said, "Well, what do you mean?" He goes, "There's nothing to do around here." And I said, "Well, what do you want to do?" He goes, "I want to play football." And I says, "Okay, I'll tell you what. I'll look into it. Give me a week, and you know, you start talking to your friends. And I tell you right now, if one person quits, then it's over with." And so I did. And a week later, I came back, found out that there was a Metro League in Grand Rapids, and Burton didn't have a team. It was for fifth and sixth and seventh and eighth. So I ended up wanting to coach the seventh and eighth grade kids. And I played football at Central High School, but I was basically a bench warmer. I was like Rudy. And so I sat a lot watching the way the coaches were coaching. And I said to myself, I remember my senior year, that if I ever have an opportunity to coach, I'm going to coach them my way. And that was the opportunity back in 75. We met them the first game of the season because they're the undefeated champions and we're the new kids in the block. And we beat them 42-7. And then it was a 12-game schedule, and we met them at the championship game at East Grand Rapids. We were undefeated, and they had the one loss. And at East Grand Rapids, we beat them. And as soon as we won, they had probably 35 kids with five coaches, parent coaches, and I was the only coach on my team. And with 14 kids, and once we beat them, they turned the lights off and gave me a trophy that was pretty small. So I remember the kids looking at it, and you have to remember these are kids from the Burton Heights area in that Granville Avenue area, and they were accustomed to disappointment when I promised them that if you work hard, you'll get a big reward at the end, and it ends up being a small trophy. And they were kind of discouraged about that. But they learned something that day. They learned that it's not about the trophy and the size of it. It was the way we worked together as a team and believing in each other. And had a good time. And I say everybody was a captain. We beat people 72-0, 54-0, 36-0. We had six shutouts in a row. And I say we went undefeated the whole season. And I tell you, to see those kids, it was something.
You made a difference in your lives.
Yes, I did. I look at it and not think nothing of it, you know, but it comes back. You know, what goes around comes around. And so it was a good time.
The definition of a clown, a comic performer who employs slapstick or similar types of physical humor, often in a mime style. Clowns have a varied tradition with a significant variations in costumes and performance. The most recognizable clowns are those that commonly wear outlandish costumes. Flamo, the safety clown, has been a professional firefighter, certified medical first responder, and hazmat technician since 1978. Flamo was introduced in 1984 to promote fire safety awareness to audiences of all ages in a unique way.
I had a dream of Bozo. Clown. So it was like 2 o'clock in the morning. I ran downstairs. I'm an artist, so I started sketching different types of clowns. And then it hit me that I'm a firefighter. Why not make a fireman clown out of this? With Bozo, I came up with Flamo, the fire safety clown. And that's how it first started. And then when I introduced it to the fire chief, and I ended up doing school programs. So every day I went to work, I was a Flamo, the clown. All day until about 2 o'clock, and I remember that first year it was working really good. And then I said to the fire chief at the time, "What happens, because I'm a nozzle person, I'm the person on the fire truck, what happens if we have a fire and I'm doing a school program?" Well, he said, "Put a video in and, you know, go put the fire out." And so I said to him, "Will I get in trouble?" And he said, "No." So for 2 months, I was doing the Flamo, the clown, at schools, at the fire station. And one day, we had a fire down the street from the fire station. I was doing a school program as Flamo, And I put the video in, jumped in the jump seat, put my mask on, went to the house, put the fire out, came out, took my mask off, and everybody in the neighborhood was laughing because I was a clown. So I'm a juggler, so I picked up rocks and started juggling. Well, the next day I got reprimanded. And I asked him, why am I getting reprimanded? He goes, well, I had a lot of complaints, and it was non-professional. And when he said non-professional, that really hurt me. And so I said to him, I want to let you know right now that 2 weeks ago we had a basement fire at 3 in the morning, and I went down there and put the fire out. And when I came out, I went up to the tree. I said to the family, I'm glad everybody got out of the house. A little five-year-old boy walked up to me and said, Flame of the Clown was there at school, and he told us to meet at a tree. And I said to the fire chief, and he said, I'm not professional. So that was the day I stopped doing it for the fire department I worked for. Like a clown, I pretend to be glad. Now there's some sad things known to men, but ain't too much sad. The tears of a clown when there's no one around. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, baby.
If this has been a real emergency, this is what you would have heard.
I knew one person, and that was 10 years ago. Now I know people from throughout the United States and Canada that know me as Flame of the Clown, and I'm really proud of that.
Performances include the Detroit Fire Department Clown Team, National Fallen Firefighters Memorial, Firefighter Cancer Foundation, Muscular Dystrophy Association, Make-A-Wish Foundation, and the Michigan Burn Center, and various other charities. George Hernandez is definitely passionate about fire safety.
Isn't it rich? Isn't it queer? Losing my timing this late in my career. But where are the clowns? Send in the clowns. Well, maybe next year.